black mold in it, just take it down. Yeah, cause that'll kill folks.
Yeah.
You know, but, and there's so many other additives, so many other additives. So, I'm following God's lead, for God's sake. Somebody said, why you did that, and so why you, you know, because it was in my power.
Alright.
It's something in your power to do something that is good and right, you ought to do it. I thank God for it, and we just believe that God is gonna help us.
Amen.
All the way, help us all the way. You know, we thank God for what the church did. You know, we thank God for it, but it just took more. It take more, if it was in your power to do it, God done spoke to you, you better do it.
Amen.
Yeah, the Lord let you know that he's able to restore. He's able to put back. He's able to, you know, above.
Yeah.
We think, ask him. God is able to do it.
Yeah, do it.
So I'm trusting God.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, so we're almost together. Matter of fact, almost is not enough. Is that right? You got to come back. You got to come back.
Yeah.
We can have citizens. Somebody want to know, well, who's going to pastor? I said, I'm going to bring it up to Pentecost. That's the way it has to go. That's the way we do.
You know?
That's the way, this is the way we do in the AOA church. You know, diocese bishop is the one that bring it up. You know, then the senior bishop and the bishop board are the ones that put somebody else there. Somebody asked me, and they have it. You know? When they did, I said, no, I'm glad it's not in my hand.
Mm-hmm. Right, Jesus.
I said, it's going to the bishop board and the bishop.
Mm-hmm.
If anybody asked me, who's going to have it, you tell me it's going to the
bishop.
It's going to the bishop board and the senior bishop. That's where it's going.
Mm-hmm.
Thank God. I'm glad that it's not in my hand.
Thank God.
Yeah, because people have a tendency, you know. God is good all the time.
Yes,
thank you,
Lord,
for being the God that you are. Thank you and praise your holy name. God is good all the time. Thank God for all things in Jesus' name. Continue to pray that God bless this AOA Church of God.
Yes.
That God send lead and guidance for us. Because we're going through a barren land.
Yes.
We're going through some rough times.
Yes.
Huh? Rough times and folks are confused. They don't know what to do. And God has sent strong delusions because they wouldn't do right. Not only that, God wants you to know who they are.
Yes.
According to 1 John 2, somebody read that, 2 and 19. I think we got it about right. 1 John 2 and 19. Then we're gonna, that's not what we're going to talk about tonight. But according to this,
they went out from us.
What the Bible said?
They went out from us.
They went out from us.
But they were not of us.
Why?
They were not of us.
Because they were not of us.
For
if they had been of us,
they would no doubt have continued.
That's
with
what
us.
God said.
Yeah.
God said it. Well, you know, they were going to do better. They were going to earn more money. They were going to learn more. They were going for whatever reason. God said, God wants you to recognize who they are.
All right.
Mm-hmm. Tell them I said it. Then tell them the scripture we read.
Uh-huh.
seen them running, hallelujah, seemed like in another dream. And they were running from Bishop Phillip. Bishop Phillip didn't look like himself. They were just running, and running, and running. Hallelujah. They're scattering and running. It's going all kind of ways. And you know that's happening.
Yeah.
Just like I dreamed. I went to the light of the world. And was a minister that was, he started his ministry at the light of the world. So did I. And he said, he told the dream, I was amazed. I said, that's the same thing that I dreamed. He seen the same thing. And I said, in this day, I seen this day. I know what it was. This day. I seen people just running from one place to another. Running from the word of God. Running from what was right. See, a lot of people don't know it. If the minister go wrong, if leaders go wrong in his church, the AOA church have a covenant. Huh?
All right.
I said the AOA church have a covenant with God. As long as you don't deny his name, God gave that to Bishop Phillip, that covenant. God brought it to me. As long as you don't deny God's name, you can come right here. I don't care how bad that minister go. We're going to have some bad ones. Is that right?
Yes,
y'all don't want to testify, but I can say it. Y'all don't want to, you know, to agree with it. But yeah, we have had some bad ministers.
Mm-hmm.
And some of y'all know some of them.
Yeah.
But let me tell you something. That covenant that we had with God. Hallelujah. We can make it in.
Yeah.
If Jacob be lost, Israel won't lose their reward.
Yeah.
God is a good God.
Yes,
and he's worthy to be praised. I'm going to tell you something else. Don't ever let nobody cause you to go wrong.
Amen.
Nobody.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That's why I stand up, so, and I'm going to stand up. If I don't have a friend, I'm going to stand up. I know I got a friend in Jesus. I had some old dreams. How many had some dreams in your life?
Yeah.
I had some dreams. I remember going into a place. I went in this place, it looked like in the back of a church. And I seen, looked around. Everybody in that place had a table. Everybody had one, but when I came, I didn't have one.
Mm-hmm.
And I heard somebody say, if you bow down, we'll give you a table.
Mm-hmm.
I'm telling y'all something, I don't tell y'all it, but I've been holding it for years.
Mm-hmm.
If you bow down, we'll give you one. But I heard another voice say, how many ever heard that other voice?
Mm-hmm.
That other voice said, you can't bow down. You're God's man.
Yeah.
For you belong to God. You got to know who you belong to.
Lord, Lord.
If you don't know who you belong to. You be doing some of everything.
Uh-huh.
You know. Death, you know, I don't want nothing.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, I have told certain women, I don't want nothing.
Yeah.
I got enough.
Amen.
Yeah, God been too good for me.
Lord, amen.
To turn and go another way.
Yeah.
Yes. Now, if y'all go back and tell it, now y'all tell it just like I see it.
Yes, sir.
Tell it just like I see it.
Right.
Is that right? Don't folk have a tendency to go back and tell things, then get it. Yeah, but he said this about you, and I ain't said nothing about you. Now, if they ever tell me you said it, I'm going to call one of y'all. Now come here and tell you what I said. That's what I'm going to do. And I'm coming like that.
Yes.
I seen one of my former pastors in, you didn't do.
Mm-hmm.
You end up going to jail sometime. If you ain't do it, you ought to defend yourself.
That's right, Bishop.
I seen somebody agree to something that they told me they didn't do. I said, wait a minute. I said, man, why don't you tell them the truth? Don't tell an untruth for them to give you two or three years and exclude 15 or 20. If I'm telling the truth, I go down. Tell the truth. You do whatever you want to do. But I'm gonna depend on God. God is a good God, I thought I just said that. But the main thing is that latter part of that verse. So you'll know them. You'll know them. Folk do things, they go out and say all kinds of stuff, why they left, and so forth and so on. But there it is right there. And God would, before they ever left, God knew them. If God put you here, God saved you here, God delivered you here, you know some things. And they said, well, once upon a time, God told me to come here. But it ain't like God. He changed his mind. Leave that right there. God is good, ain't
it? Yes.
God, if God tell you something, God save you here, this is the place you ought to be. Once the devil gets you on his territory, he's going to wear you out. And it's been just like Bishop Phillips had taught us. Once you leave, you can leave somewhere else and come here. But once you leave the AOA's church, most of those people go down. I've seen it over and over. They go down. So this is your best bet to stay right here. Because you got a covenant with the Lord. God is good and he's good all the time. I never go along with anything wrong. If I find out that I'm wrong, then I'm going to go against myself. I'll go right before the Lord. Get on my face. Hallelujah. But God will speak to your heart. He'll let you know who he is. I'm going to tell everything. Sometimes it'll be years before I tell. You know, tell it all. Come sooner or later. Somebody said, I'm going to tell it. Sooner or later, I'm going to tell it. Right, then, if whoever is dealing with, they come straight to him, I'm going to say it right in his face. Oh, I believe God. I believe God. Thank you, Jesus. Evening, who was in prayer. Lord, shall I have an awesome weapon in my hand. An awesome weapon. Hallelujah. It ain't nothing out of ordinary. It's simple. It's Jesus. In my hand, I thank God for Jesus. He's awesome. He's awesome. He can do anything but fear. We're going to talk a little tonight. Thank God my time. I already taught a lesson. Hallelujah. My time got up. Don't want to hold you long. Tonight we're going to talk to you about something we have already talked about. Since 1980, I think I don't talk all through the Bible. So I ain't too much I can teach that is new. We're going to simply talk about faith tonight. Remember what I'm telling you tonight. Y'all write that scripture down. Write it down so you'll know. I think I heard Deacon Simon say it some time ago, that same scripture. He heard it from somewhere. Mm-hmm. But it's telling the truth.
Yeah.
And you need to know these people. We had We had an individual to leave. You know, not anybody here left there. But just some years ago. When the individual left, he called back trying to get people to come out with him. That's a trick of the enemy to try to get you with an undercover that you have with God. They do things like that. When they leave, see, the devil is not going to let them be satisfied. being by themselves. They gonna beg for somebody else to come with them. I want you to know tonight that you have arrived and you're in the right place. Don't let the enemy fool you out. You can make it in God's kingdom. This is your ticket into God's kingdom, right through here. Amen. And let me tell you, the way I am, folks are not gonna love me. Mm-hmm. They're not gonna love me because the devil, I will expose the devil. He knew. He knew. That's why he tell you that don't tell if you could. They'll tell you that. Be quiet. Don't say it, you're eating. And that's the way you have to be.
Yeah.
I'm like that because my daddy was like that. Not my blood dad, my spiritual dad. Bishop Phillip was like that. I'm like that. That's the way I was raised up. To tell it. How many of you were raised up to tell it? If it's wrong, you better not tell me. You better not tell me. God sure does speak against what's wrong.
Yeah.
Amen. The church belongs to God.
Yeah.
I'm here to defend God's church. Yeah, our place here to defend his church. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Tonight we're going to simply talk about faith. We're going to try to talk about building your faith. Building your faith. Every one of us already have faith, don't we? Mm-hmm. How y'all know you have faith?
You
got to measure your faith. Alright. In simplicity, you know you have faith because you walked in that door. You came in, you took a seat. If you ain't have any faith, you'll stand up. You would say, if I take a seat, then I'm going to fall. A seat gonna fall. Mm-hmm. I think I've been in the church, and the seat did fall. In the back.
Yeah.
Because it's a weak seat. Yeah. But if you didn't have any faith, you would never go out and crank your car. You don't even think about it. You just go ahead and turn the key. If it don't crank, you'll wonder why it didn't crank. Isn't that right? And most of the time when you go out, everything working properly, it's going to crank. Yeah. So you have faith. That measure of faith. That measure of faith. But although we have faith, we need to build on our faith. Yeah. You need to build on our faith. Romans 10 and 17 tells us. So then faith.
Come it by hearing.
So then faith. Faith. Trust and belief. Confidence. Uh-huh. Yeah. Confidence. Reliance. Yeah. Perseverance. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And hope and expectation. So then what? Faith. By hearing.
And hearing by the word of God.
And hearing by the word of God. Mm-hmm. So when I looked at that scripture, I said, that book was what the Lord brought to mind out of there. So then faith. You got to hear the word of God. Hear. Mm-hmm. It's good sometimes to have some way that means. So you can hear the word. You know, have Bible ears sometimes. Listen to that scripture on faith. That will help build your faith up by hearing. Hearing what God did and how he did. Mm-hmm. This will build your faith up. When I first got saved, the only way that I had edited faith was I knew I had received the Holy Ghost.
Uh-huh.
I knew this. And I said to myself, if God fill by instruction. And when you follow instruction, then I found out back then that God will fill you with the Holy Ghost. Sometimes we be calling them, and sound like they were talking right directly to me. They may have been just saying, they said, but call them like you want them. I stretch out on God. Put something and call them like you, like the house burning up. Hallelujah. And you need to get out. You know, you got to really call them. You got to be with
them.
Thank you. I was used to that. I was used to folk telling me to get more enthused. But yet still, that was here. Faith coming by hearing. And hearing what?
By
the word of God. It's telling you, you need to hear the word of God. The word of God. If you hear God's word, that will build your faith up. And that's what the church folk need today.
Hallelujah.
They need to build their faith up.
Hallelujah.
In God. Faith in God, I expect God to do what he said. Yeah. Then I know that God will do it. I have that confidence in him. Hallelujah. Because of things that did happen to us, I think about the time when I used to work with a welder. I worked at Mobile Steel with a welder. And being young and didn't know much, that welder scrapped that. Do that off. See, you can't look at it. It worse than the sun. Burned my eyes. And you come out painful. I said, how am I going to get rid of this? You come out painful. I had that burning. Big actor burning. Somebody said, take a hot potato and put it on your eyes. I cut it. Put it around. Said to draw all that out. But this particular evening, before I did it real good, my mother came in, laid hands on me. As soon as she did, I jumped up. Pain and everything was gone. I knew right then, I was a sinner then, sure enough, a sinner. Bad sinner. Wasn't good for nothing. It would have been good for me to die. It wasn't fit to live. But God healed me. Evidently, God looked down the line and called those things that be not as though they were. Yeah, God seen me become a saved person. And tonight, I'm using that for an example. God evidently seen this night, letting you know that God will do it, to build your faith up. Come by hearing. And hearing what? The word of God. Thank God for it. Hebrews 11:1 says, it says, now faith. Some people, they talking about right now. They said, now faith. You know, I think they're using that just for an expression for me. And they could be right. Could be right. Now faith is the substance. Things hopeful. I mean, I'm hoping for something right now. Yeah, it takes faith. Yeah. I think Habakkuk 2:4 said what? That the just shall live by faith. Y'all know about that. The just. Yeah. God, the one that God has made righteous, shall live by faith. Live by faith. Every day we ought to live by faith. Yeah. But now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Hallelujah. I used to hear the old sister. consider that. The Lord just spoke to me through my spirit. He said, buy the first 1,000 blocks. I bought the first 1,000 blocks and set them out on the yard in the black jack. Y'all ever heard of the black jack?
Yes,
the black jack sound like what? Sound like a place they all steal. And the black jack, I bought those 1,000 blocks. And I don't know that, maybe they sat there a year before we ever did anything with them. But I did just what God told me to do. And those people who said that they're not here anymore, I'm going to tell you. And my overseer went back and told him. He said, well, Reverend Critter said he's going to build a church here. They sent me word that if you build it, you're going to build it by yourself. It probably will shake me now. When I was young like that, then God speaking to me too, didn't move me. It was just like a Bible word. They just said something. I kept right on going. And you know God showed his hand. God is that type of God. God is a God that works when you expect something to happen. I didn't know all what God was going to do. I didn't know it, but I just felt like I had to do it. I may never felt like that.
Yes,
I had to do it. I didn't know all what God was going to do.
Mm-hmm.
All God just told me to buy the 3,000.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't look ahead and see how they were going to go up or what. The Lord sent a deacon all the way from Pensacola. He came over on Saturday and laid those blocks. I think about one time he brought another young man with him to help him. All the other time was him. Him. And we tore those blocks and did everything. But faith comes by. That was faith.
Mm-hmm.
I believe what God said. God told me to do something. How many always believe God? I believe God tell me to do something. I may not even look into it. I just go and do it. Because he said, I'm not trying to see what God's going to do.
Mm-hmm.
But all I know, this is what he told me to do.
Yeah.
So I just did it. Mm-hmm. But after you do what God has told you, God will step in, and I know him. I know him from that, you know, from that incident. That he would step in and do the rest.
That's right, Bishop.
God would do it. He would do the rest. pot on. Ain't nothing in the pantry. I don't put the pot on, I'm gonna wait. God will make a way out of nowhere.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, he'll do it. In our younger days, I seen, hallelujah, my mother go out and work and struggle. And when I woke up, there were five of us in the house. I hardly ever seen dad. But my mother went to work, she went at the hospital. And the lady at the hospital was sending food home. I'm preaching a little different than that. Send food home off the job that evidently this for your children. Then I forgot what day it was. I'm telling y'all some incidents. Either Thanksgiving or Christmas. My sister, I was too young to remember. My sister used to tell me that, yeah, it was one of the holidays, I think it was Thanksgiving. We didn't have nothing to eat. She said, a duck. A duck. A cross. You know, Underwood used to be that, where they had the machines. It was Underwood on Worcester Avenue. Said, a duck flew in. And he flew right in the back door where I was. Hallelujah, bro. I thought about that. I said, I was there, I need something to eat. God was making me, that duck flew in there, you know what happened. That was our Mia right there. God is for real, y'all.
Yes.
Don't let nobody fool you. God is for real.
Yes.
Tell one more. There was time Mother Cousin and I had got kind of low on food. I took my fishing rod and I went out to Dog River on that pier. Mm-hmm. When you come in there,
yes.
You your brother probably done seen four fishing. I went out there, took whatever bait I had, threw it out there, I was catching some big crows. You know how fishermen used to get that. It was a big crow. Mother Pierce can finish the other stories. But we went on another pier. She can tell you about the time we went out in the water and picked up a whole lot of oysters. Picked them up. Hallelujah.
Yes.
If you just have faith in God.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Faith in God.
Yes.
The old preacher said, it hasn't been always easy, children.
Yes, sir.
Uh-uh. But God, when you got faith in him, when you live for God,
yes, sir.
God will make a way out of no way.
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
I ain't gonna tell nobody to try to act
yes.
Like I've been. You know, I've been pretty good all my life. But I can look back and tell you down through the years
yes.
How God blessed me,
yes.
Made a way for me.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. When folk tried to discourage me,
mm-hmm.
Said, you shouldn't pay tithes.
Mm-hmm.
Said, why should you pay a tithe? Why should you pay tithes to a millionaire?
Mm-hmm.
I have to tell y'all, that's probably done told the church before. Y'all, I done told y'all, probably done forgot. But I was in the latrine, and some older men was in there. This was during Bishop Phillips' day. And they were talking about rally we was having. See, back in those days, we had rallies, $100 rallies.
Yeah.
I don't think y'all could have stood it.
Mm-hmm.
That's when we're trying to buy Philip Temple. $100 rally, $50 rally. And Mother Curtis had two of the children at home then. Yeah, two of them, you know, maybe one. And the two came, the other one came along, Stephanie came along, Bishop Philip. But I was in the latrine and we had teach somebody, so I'm gonna do the same thing they get to do. Don't take it, then, uh-uh. Take the part I'm finna tell you. This is the part you wanna hear. See, then God spoke to them. And they were speaking that, not for themselves, or both of them did the same thing. I was the third part of that. And so I take some of my tithe money and pay my rally. Another voice, I mean, you know, that's why you need the Holy Ghost. Another voice said, you can't do that. Men I respected, men I loved, men I dealt with, Sunday school men. But the Lord spoke and said, I can't do it. Certain one of us can't do certain things. You know, then there's some other people that do anything they can. They don't care what they do. Don't let them cohesive you to do it wrong. But have faith in God. Have faith in God. And sure enough, I needed a way to raise my rally money. I was inquiring from God, how can I get it? Deacon Alan Johnson. Curtis, and when I was a brother, he said, we need somebody to clean the floors. And I was good at it. So me and Brother Lockett cleaned those floors. And they paid me for cleaning the floors right through the check. Paid me. I think that it paid Mother Curtis rather and my rather. My rather money. And God blessed. Kept on blessing. Kept on blessing. Sometimes you get the pumps to flow when you do the right thing. I didn't tell you all that to get you to pay tithes, but I told you that to have faith in God. See, sometimes we get it wrong, but I'm telling you, that's for you to have faith. You trust God. Because most Adamville people pay tithes anyway. Yeah. But God started opening doors for me. Bless him. Whatever my hands touched, the Lord blessed it. Whatever I was doing, God blessed it and brought me on through. Thank God for Jesus. But you got to have faith in him. Trust him. And listen to his word. God's word would increase your faith. Build you up. Sometimes that's what we need. A little faith. Give me a little faith. And it will be like he wants us to be, we can go where he wants us to go. Always trust God. If God's voice come in your ear and tell you the right thing to do, do it. Yeah. If they're going to criticize, don't tell them. If they're going to criticize you for doing the right thing, don't tell them. Just keep it to yourself. Because you sometimes when you're young and you know, and you're not strong as they are, don't be telling everybody what you're doing. Just do it.
That's
the best way to do it. I'm telling everybody what I'm doing. No. Folks used to sit back and watch. Especially on the Bishop Arias time. You know, they make little strong. I got to get out of here, y'all. Wrong strong remark. Say, he Bishop Arias, boy. Because I worked with him. Because I was doing the right thing that I was supposed to do. I had some enemies. How many know you can have enemies, right? In the church. Beware. When all men speak well of you. It was too many men saying good things about you. So you had to beware. When all men, just don't be one of those who speak, you know. Sometimes you don't know who you entertain. Because some have entertained angels.
Unaware.
How many know that the minister in the church is the angel? Read the Revelation sometime. He's the angel of the church. You be careful how you speak. Because you can bring a thing up on you. You may go good for a long time. Hallelujah. I've seen people doing real good for a long time. Hallelujah. Thank God nobody that, you know, healed me. dead water that way. The nurse went in the water, they mouth looked moist and everything. God gave it to them. You don't never know who will have to be a drink of water. God is good. Beware about the things you do as you travel. Hallelujah. Because the very tongue you use may cause your flesh to suffer. You let your little tongue wag down. Sometimes you don't know who you're talking about. You heard others do it, so you decide to do it. Don't be doing what other folk do. But we need to build our faith up. Build your faith up not in me, but in God. Not in someone else, but build your faith up in God. Hebrews 12:2. Hebrews 12:2, let us know, looking unto Jesus, who is what? The author. Author means what? He is the one that starts our faith in this. Sure, he's the one who wrote the book. But he's the one, this is talking about, he's the one that started. Yeah. Who is the author and finisher of our faith. Who you gonna look to?
Jesus.
From now on, if you haven't been looking to him, from now on, the scripture is telling you tonight, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. For what? The joy.
The joy that was set before him.
Set before us.
Endured the cross.
He did what?
Endured
the cross.
Despising the shame.
Despising the shame.
And is set down at the right hand.
Sat down at the right hand
of the throne of God.
He sat in authority. Jesus is. He's the one that in authority and power. We look into him, not man. We look to God. Not your preacher, not your pastor, not anyone in the church, not someone you know that have done great things. Years ago, they used to really talk about War Robinson and Shambo and all them. They really believe that they could do it. But they were looking to the wrong one. God used those men. And you don't want to get God mixed up with the people he used. Nobody greater than the Lord Jesus Christ. Sometimes you need to read and see what the book of Hebrews is really talking about. Hebrews is talking about that Christ is better than any other source. That's what it's telling. I got to come down, y'all. God is good. But you need him. Why? Because what? We walk by faith and not by sight. Yeah. Walk by faith. I believe that God can do it. I believe he's going to do it. I have confidence in it. That he's the one that can do it. Without faith, it is impossible. Those of you who are trying to please him, it's impossible for you to please him. Without, you don't have it. Without faith, it is impossible to please him. Without faith, I don't see how you're going to make it in his kingdom. Without faith. You need faith in order to go into God's kingdom. God is a good God. Thank God for the little faith I have. If you have faith as a grain of mustard seed, you can say to what? Yonder mountain. Hallelujah. Be thou removed. Not talking about a real mountain. But it's talking about big things that happen in your life. heard, I was found to explain, he said, that grain of mustard seed is small. It's small, that stayed with me down through the years. Yeah, yeah. Maybe about 50 years ago, he said this. He said, but that mustard seed was pure mustard. Nothing but pure mustard. Yeah. Nothing but pure faith. Pure faith. If you got pure faith, I'm talking about nothing but faith. Little of it, nothing but nothing but faith. It'll work for you. Mm-hmm. Thank God for Jesus.
Yes.
Jesus was on his way, hallelujah, to go down, hallelujah, to Jairus' house to heal his daughter as he went. And Matthew 9 and 20.
But Jesus turned him a crowd.
He said, behold, let's do that. That one, 9 and 20. Let's do okay. 9 and 20 through the 27th. He said, and behold,
a woman which was diseased.
A woman which was diseased.
With an issue of blood.
With an issue of blood.
12 years.
12 long. Let's put a little in there. It's all right for me to put a little in there. 12, because it may be short to some people, but it's 12 long years. I said, sometime after 4 years with me, it gets to be long. I did 4 years in the Air Force. That seemed like it was long. So 12 years, so it never got to be long. But the Bible said what? 12 years.
Mm-hmm. She came behind him.
Said, but disease was for issue of blood for 12 years. Came behind him
and touched the
hallelujah, glory to God. Bless his high name. Somebody need Jesus, right?
All right.
Thank you, Jesus. The Bible said, and touched the hem of his garment.
Amen.
Yes, didn't touch him, y'all.
That's right.
If it had been me, I thought I had to grab.
All right.
I thought I had to never get a good hold. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Some of us like that. Everybody like somebody, all I need to do is just get it close up just to touch him. She just wanted to touch the hem. That's sure enough. That's sure enough just touching us. You know, not him, just a part of what was on him. Yeah, and a minister, as they be preaching, it'll come to him. Well, he had power in his hand. Power. Hallelujah. On his back. Power. You said power all over him.
Yes.
Even the things that he had on, he had so much power.
Yes.
That was even in him. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Even in him. I got to get out of him.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Thank you.
Power
yes.
over him.
Yes.
And you preaching. Now y'all hear me preaching, y'all hear that other stuff come up. So even with power in his voice, walk down to Lazarus' grave and call Lazarus by his name. Hallelujah. Here come Lazarus. Step out of the grave. Came for power in his voice. Nobody touched him here. He just called
him.
Other kind of woman. Touched the hem of his garment. That's all you got to do. Faith coming by hearing. Hearing the word of God. Just don't take the word in, you know, and just throw it out there. It's coming in to help you all. You ought to say, all I need to do is just touch.
Hallelujah!
The hymn of God.
Mm-hmm.
You hear it, use it like that. Hallelujah. Because he can make you whole. Him is coming. For she said within herself,
if I may but touch his garment,
if I may but touch his garment,
I shall be whole.
I shall.
Hallelujah.
I don't know whether y'all knew Bishop Finn, but Bishop Finn said, all of our shall come to pass. Hallelujah. All his shall. God, if God said he shall, it's going to be. Jesus turned.
Turned him about.
Him about.
And when he saw her.
When he saw her.
He said, daughter.
He said, daughter.
Be of good comfort.
Be of good comfort.
Thy faith had made thee whole.
You, how many know you need some faith?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. You're going to come back here. Thy faith have made thee whole.
Amen. And the woman said, was made whole from that hour.
Now, hallelujah. It works.
Yeah.
God, hold the word. It's real, y'all. Yeah. How many can see it's real? I can see it's real.
Hallelujah.
I see real all over the God's word.
Hallelujah.
I know that it happened. Because some little things are happening to me. I know that it happened. Then that 28 and 29 verse.
And when he was coming to the house.
The Bible says, and when he would come into the house.
The blind man came to him.
The blind man can't see.
Right.
Hallelujah. Somebody think you got to see. But no, you could be blind.
Uh-huh.
You come to Jesus. The blind man came into the house. The blind man came to him.
And Jesus said unto them.
And Jesus said unto them.
Believe ye that I am able to do this.
It said men.
Yes.
Not man, but men.
Amen.
Came in. How many know God labor?
Yes.
Yeah, God labor to do it for you and me and somebody else all at the same time.
Yes.
He can heal all of us at once. He's able. He come to here. He had a double duty. Somebody said he had a multitask. Yeah, but he was able to do it. He could do more than that. Hallelujah. And what else happened?
He says, believe ye that I am able to do this?
He said, do you believe that I am able to do this?
They said unto him.
It's about you.
Yeah.
It's about you. It ain't about me. It's not about the one, hallelujah, nowadays that is praying for you. It's about you. Do you believe? Do you believe in Jesus?
Hallelujah.
Do you believe that Jesus can do it?
Mm-hmm.
If you believe that Jesus can do it, he will do it.
Yes, he will.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Thank you.
Do you believe I am able to do this?
Lord.
That's what he said. And?
They said unto him.
Yea, Lord.
Yea,
Lord. Now we'll say it like this. Yes, Lord.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's what we'll say it. And he accepted that. However you say it, God accepted. He knew what you mean. He already knew. Even though sometimes we don't answer God, and he hears your cry within you.
Yeah.
And he will do it. Yea, Lord. And?
Then touched he their eyes.
Saying.
According to your faith.
According to Richard's faith.
Your faith.
According to Dora's faith.
Your faith.
According to somebody else's faith.
Your
faith. But God said, according to your faith.
Oh, yeah.
Amen.
You need faith.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And I reckon that's why we're talking about building your faith.
Mm-hmm.
According to your faith. You can be made.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Be it done unto you. You can be made whole. How many want to be made whole?
Amen.
God can make
Thank
you whole
you.
Tonight.
Thank you.
I heard Jesus, you know, saying, he said, if thou canst believe.
Yes.
If you can just believe,
yes.
All things are possible.
Yes.
To him.
Lord.
Hallelujah. I ain't yet about to. I'm at the close of the book. All things.
Oh.
I remember when I was a young boy, they used to sing a song. They said, all things are possible.
Hey.
If you're home.
Lord.
Believe. Hallelujah. All things are possible.
Hallelujah.
You
Yes.
But help my unbelief. Lord, increase our faith. Hallelujah.
Yes, God.
He's able. He's able.
Yes,
Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Faith cometh by hearing.
Uh-huh.
Hear the word of God.
Lord.
That's what we need to hear more of. The word of God.
Hallelujah.
Don't rely on nothing else but God and his holy word.
Thank God.
It'll do it for you. It'll bring you through whatever you need.
Yes.
However you need it. Healing in your body. Hallelujah. Believe his word.
Yes.
You need a better job. There it is. Believe God.
Yes.
If you truly want it. Thank you, Jesus. You need a home, food, whatever you need.
Amen.
Hallelujah. God is an awesome.
Yes, he is.
He's an awesome weapon in our hand.
Mm.
The weapon that I will walk. Putting down strong. Thank God for Jesus. I'm glad.
Hallelujah.
I'm glad I learned it.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. When I was a young man, I had a rough road to travel. As I traveled this road, I needed it.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus. I needed some faith to go
around.
I needed some help. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
God, to bring me on through.
Yeah.
I got news for you today. I'm a living witness.
Nah.
You bring me through. I'm in the seat of it. I'm here.